Well, more news. A KATV News Watch 7 exclusive now. A big honor for small-town Nebraska.
From the ashes at Ground Zero, a piece of the Twin Towers finds a new home in Bennington.
KATV News Watch 7's Michelle Bandour shows us a piece of history and how a volunteer firefighter brought it home.
An unbreakable bond among firefighters, a bond no tragedy can break.
And it hit home, so.
Even 1,200 miles away, volunteer firefighters in Bennington will never forget the loss of their brothers at Ground Zero.
Just thinking about all the people that died and all the people that were trying to rescue people that died, you know, just really goes to the heart.
Now the bond they feel in their hearts, they can reach out and touch with their hands.
It's a cold, rusty piece of metal and your hand's dirty when you're done, but nobody cares. You know, you brush your hand off and you go back and say, you know, I just touched a piece of history.
A piece of steel from the World Trade Center, now inside the Bennington Fire Station, thanks to Ben Tizer. Seen here in the blue helmet, Ben joined the volunteer fire department right after 9/11.
One of the things I wanted to do, I knew I couldn't, was go there and help in some way. And so I started looking around the local community.
The Port Authority of New York saved thousands of pieces of the Twin Towers and provided us these pictures. While most will be part of the new memorial, more than 1,000 needed a new home.
They said, who else has a piece of steel in Nebraska? She said, nobody. You guys are the only organization that has a piece of steel that's been approved under this program.
So Ben sent his letter to the Port Authority September 11th, 2009, then went to New York last month to bring Nebraska's piece home. He took pictures as New York crews loaded the 6,800-pound, 13-foot-long beam onto a truck.
Ben managed to keep his plans a secret. After hauling the 3.5-ton piece of steel all the way from New York to here in Bennington, he kept it hidden for 9 days here at R&S Trailers. He tells me he had to tell his wife, but he didn't share that secret with his boss.
I don't think it sunk into him the magnitude of what this is going
to
do.
A small town with a big tribute to fallen heroes.
What better way to honor them than to build a memorial on from a piece that affected so many lives around the country.
In Bennington, Michelle Bandour, KETV, Newswatch 7.
Now, Bennington firefighters plan to make the steel beam part of a memorial at its new fire station, and they'll dedicate it in September, the 10-year anniversary of the 9/11 attacks.
And the fire department provided us with even more exclusive photos. We're showing them to you in a slideshow on KETV.com.